Hello everyone, I'm Simran Kaur from Shiv Jyoti Educational Group, and today we'll do revision of all our previous chapters. So here today we'll start with revision of two chapters, chapter 15 and chapter 17. So we'll begin with revision of chapter 15, which is some natural phenomena. Here is a list of few important points which need to be remembered. In this chapter we discussed charged and uncharged bodies. In a nature, there are only two types of bodies, whether it will be a charged or it will be an uncharged body. Now, initially, all bodies are uncharged unless we charge them. How can you make any uncharged body charge? By rubbing or friction. Then we discussed interaction of charges. Now, there are two types of charges, positive charge and negative charge. So when you will bring opposite charges together, then you will see that there is a force of attraction between those two charged bodies. But when you will bring two like charges near each other, then you will see a repulsion between those two charged bodies. Then electroscope. Now this is a device which is used to detect the type of charge. Now if you will touch any charged body, okay, suppose I have given you any body and I told you, I asked you to identify whether it is a charged or uncharged body. So how will you identify? By using any electroscope. So in this chapter we discussed gold leaf electroscope, in which we make use of two thin strips of gold. That is why we are calling it gold leaf electroscope. And what is electroscope? It is an instrument which is used to detect the charge. Then lightning. Okay, lightning, during rainy season it is very common, we see lightning, we see an electric discharge in the sky. So what is that? That term which we have coined to it is lightning. Now what happened there up above in the sky? Look, heavy clouds are there in the rainy season and there is friction between them. And we discussed in this topic that due to rubbing, due to friction, the body get charged. So similarly, up above in the sky, clouds are also getting charged. Now some clouds are positive, some are negative. So when those clouds interact with each other, there is a discharge of electricity or charges between those clouds, and that is how we see that electric spark in the sky. Now to prevent our buildings, what do we use? We use again a safety device which is known as lightning conductor. So you can define lightning conductor as a device which is used to protect our building from the effect of lightning. As you know that I told you that lightning always looks for an easiest path. So all the tall objects, tall trees, tall buildings, they will give lightning an easy path. Then in second part of this chapter, we dealt with earthquake. Now earthquake, it is a natural phenomena, it is a natural disaster. So what is the cause of earthquake? Actually, what is the meaning of earthquake? The sudden movement in the earth's crust is known as earthquake. Now what is the reason behind this cause? Like, you know that the top layer of earth, which is crust, it is not a single piece of land. So many fragments, so many plates are present. So because of the disturbance of those plates, earthquakes are caused. Then these three terms we discussed: fault zone, focus and epicenter. Now when those plates means when they come in contact with each other, sometimes they get interlocked. Now if you have watched the video of this lecture, I told you that suppose if you are interlocking your fingers, then it will be very difficult to separate them. You need a large force to separate them. So same happens with the case of plates. When plates got interlocked with each other, a large amount of energy is built up there. So when the rocks give way, that is known as focus, and the boundary of those plates are the risky zones. So we call those boundaries of plates as fault zone or seismic zone. And the point where the rocks give way is known as focus, and it is present inside the earth's surface. Okay, Now the point which is vertically above this focus, that means which is present on the earth's surface, is known as epicenter. Understood all these three terms? Then we discussed seismograph. Okay, whenever earthquake occurs, a movement, a shock is there, which results in the generation of waves, and those waves are known as seismic waves. Now, how can we measure those waves? How can we record those waves? We use an instrument which is known as seismograph. Now, this is an instrument which is used to record those seismic waves. Then we discussed one another term, which is Richter scale. Now, Richter scale, sometimes you know that earthquakes are very mild, not very disastrous, and on the other hand, sometimes earthquakes are very disastrous. So on what basis, on which scale do we measure the energy, the power of earthquake? That scale is known as Richter scale, and the range is from 0 to 10. If earthquake is between the range 0 to 4, then we say that earthquakes are very weak, and if earthquakes are above 7, then we say that those earthquakes are very strong, which cause a disaster. So these all topics we discussed in our chapter in the video. Now it's time to go through the copy work. First, the internal questions. I hope you all have written these questions in your book or in your rough copy. Now first, what is earthing? Earthing is the process of transferring of charge from a charged body to the earth. Now sometimes whenever any body is charged and when we touch it, we make that body again uncharged. So why this happens? Because our body is also a conductor. Okay? We also act as a conductor. So all those free charges flow through us to the ground, and that process is known as earthing. What is lightning conductor? As I told you right now, lightning conductor is a device used to protect buildings from the effect of lightning. So this lightning conductor is nothing but a metallic rod which runs along the building from top to bottom. So whenever there is lightning strike, it first falls on what? On building or on this lightning conductor? It always falls on this lightning conductor, and through this metallic rod, through this lightning conductor, those charges are sent to the ground, and that is again, you can see the earthing in that process also. The next question is, what is the main cause of earthquake? The main cause of earthquake is the disturbance deep down inside the uppermost layer of the earth, or the uppermost layer is known as crust. So the disturbance in the crust results in the earthquake. What is seismogram? The characteristic of the seismic waves are recorded on the screen of a seismograph is called seismogram. Now, I told you seismograph is an instrument used to record the seismic waves. Now where we are recording those waves? On a screen, on a sheet, on a paper sheet, you can say. So that screen is known as seismogram. Now very short answer type questions. Question 1. What is tsunami? Tsunami, again a very common term. So when does it occur? When earthquakes occur under the ocean, under the sea floor, then there is disturbance in the sea. Okay, and above the sea, what is present? Water. So powerful sea waves generated by earthquake under the ocean floor is known as tsunami. Many high tides are generated, and again this results in the disaster. List 3 states in India where earthquakes are more likely to strike. Now, earthquake prone areas in India are Gujarat, Uttarakhand and Kashmir. Then short answer type question. What is a lightning strike? List safety measures against lightning strike. Now, a lightning strike is an electric discharge between the two oppositely charged clouds, because unlike charges always attract each other. So when two clouds are oppositely charged, one is negatively charged and the other one is positively charged, so there is interaction between those clouds. Okay, so that is known as lightning strike. Now what are the safety measures, what precautions you should take during that time? First, do not take shelter under a tree during lightning strike, because again trees are tall and they will give lightning an easy path. So if you are standing under a tree and this lightning strike a tree, then it will burn and it can harm you. Electric appliances should be unplugged, obvious reason. Okay, install lightning conductors to protect buildings. Okay, use this safety device in your buildings. What is the plate tectonics? Plate tectonics is the theory that deals with the surface of the earth made of lithospheric plates. It is the movement of these plates with respect to one another that results in the earthquakes, volcanoes, mountain formation, etc. Now, you know that the top layer of earth, which is crust, as I told you again in this session, in this lecture, that the crust is not even. It consists of big plates, big fragments. So the theory which is related to the plates, which is present in the crust part, that theory is known as plate tectonics. Tectonic means related to the crust. And because of the movement of those plates, earthquakes are occurred, volcanoes and mountain formation. The next question, what is epicenter? How can you measure seismic waves? As we discussed right now, the point vertically above the focus on the surface of the earth is called epicenter. And what is focus? The point where rocks give way. And we can measure seismic waves by an instrument called seismograph. Again, the same thing. Name the scale on which the destructive energy of an earthquake is measured. An earthquake measures 3 on the scale. Would it be recorded by a seismograph? Is it likely to cause much damage? Now, I told you the power, the energy of earthquake is measured on what scale? On Richter scale. So the destructive energy of an earthquake is measured on Richter scale. And what is the range of the scale? 0 to 10. So the earthquake which lies between 0 to 3 range, that will be very mild, very weak. So it will not cause any damage. An earthquake which measures 3 on the scale would be recorded by a seismograph. An earthquake of this intensity is not likely to cause any damage. Okay, it will not be disastrous, but a seismograph can record this earthquake. List 2 uses of gold leaf electroscope. Let's see what are the 2 uses. First, it is used to detect and measure the charge on a body, whether a body is charged or not. To find the nature of the charge on a body. Now we can even find out that whether it is positively charged body or negatively charged body. Long answer type questions. How would you show that like charges repel each other and unlike charges attract each other? As we discussed this in the topic interaction of charges. Now you have to prove that. We cannot say simply that like charges repel each other and unlike charges attract each other. So how can you prove it? By this activity. In this, what you have to do? You have to take a stand and ebonite and glass rod. These are 2 different types of rod. Now first you have to take 2 ebonite rods and rub it with fur. Okay, fur is a type of cloth. Now when you will rub it, when you will rub the ebonite rod with fur, what you are actually doing? You are making that ebonite rod a charged body. Now ebonite rod will get some kind of charge. Okay. On the other hand, you have to take 2 glass rods and you have to rub those glass rods with another type of cloth, which is silk. Now again, glass rod will get any kind of charge. Now what you have to do, we have to bring another ebonite rod near this ebonite rod. So what you will see that these both rods contain same type of charge, similar charges. So here we can see repulsion between these 2 rods. And on the other case, again this stand is having ebonite rod, but in this this time you will bring glass rod near this ebonite rod. So you will see that both rods are oppositely charged. So there you will see the attraction between ebonite and glass rod. So by this activity we can prove that. Last question. What should you do during an earthquake to minimize injury to ourselves? Following are the protective measures we must take during an earthquake. First, take shelter under a table during earthquake, because if something falls over you, then if you are under the table, then the table will protect you. Find a clear spot away from buildings, trees and overhead power lines, because again, if they will fall on you, you will get hurt. Stay away from tall and heavy objects. Why? Again, they are not good for you. They can harm you. If inside a vehicle, then stop driving and stay in it. That is the another protective measure which you should follow. So that was all about chapter 15.